When you look at the surfaces of seaweeds or the undersides of rocks, you'll often see beautiful tiny little colonial animals that are called bryozoans. Bryozoans are colonial organisms made up of many replicated units, each of which is genetically identical to the others. So the colony will start with a single individual called a zoet, and that will divide into two and into four and into eight and into 16, and eventually you will get a whole large colony of genetically identical individuals. Each one of those individuals lives in a little box, and then the lid of that box can open, and from the entrance of the box emerges a crown of tentacles. When you disturb the animal, then the tentacles withdraw and the little trap door closes. But apart from that similarity, bryozoans actually occur in a large range of different body forms. Many of them are encrusting, so they will grow on the surfaces of a seaweed or on the underside of a rock, and they in fact look very much like brick paving, and they are arranged in various geometric patterns. Some are in straight rows, some are in concentric circles, and some are in arcs.
I remember the first time you pointed out a bryozoan to me, I thought it was a seaweed. It was just blooming up like a plant.
Yes. So some species grow away from the surface, a bit like a grass or a bamboo, with each individual a segment, and the segments piled on top of one another, and then these will branch out to form a bush-like shape. And they're quite soft and bendy, and they're very often mistaken for either seaweeds or for hydroids. A third group of bryozoans actually have calcium carbonate skeletons, so they secrete a hard skeleton to protect themselves from predators, and then they look very much like corals. So again, each little box opens up and a set of tentacles come out, very much like would happen in a coral, but the structure of the animal is completely different from corals. So corals just have a single opening to the animal, which acts both as the mouth and as the anus. And then bryozoans are a more advanced group of animals. So they have a mouth with tentacles around it, and then they have an intestine, and then an anus that opens outside of the ring of tentacles. Some bryozoans also enter into commensal relationships with other animals. And one of the most fascinating ones that we have on the coastline here actually grows on the surface of a particular species of whelk. So it only grows on that one whelk, and that whelk always has the same bryozoan, the same red knobbly bryozoan growing on it.
Best friends for life.
Best friends for life. And they protect one another and look after one another. So the way it works is that the bryozoan is toxic. And so because the bryozoan is growing on the whelk, the predators don't attack that whelk. So it's been experimentally shown, for example, that even if you give nice hungry rock lobsters whelks with this bryozoan growing on it, then the rock lobsters won't eat it. So it provides them with protection. So what does the bryozoan get out of this? Well, it actually gets a nice little home, and then if that home was to get covered in sediment, for example, then the whelk will get up and move to a more favorable spot.
And they probably get to cruise around and get extra food as well.
Yeah, and when the whelk feeds, they probably get in a nice location where there's food particles floating in the water. There's another interesting twist to the story of the bryozoan that lives on the whelk, because they're two very brightly colored species of amphipod which come along and settle on the bryozoan and feed on it. And what's happening there is the amphipods are acquiring the toxins that are in the bryozoans and gaining the protection from those poisons. And that's why they're so brightly colored. So they've got yellow and black coloration, or blue and black coloration, which is the classic warning coloration that you get in wasps and bees, for example. So they're telling predators, no, I've got toxin inside me, I can strut around openly on the rocks, and if you feed on me, you're gonna get a nasty taste. And this has never been worked on, so it's an interesting topic for future study to find out what these toxins are.
And are all the bryozoans, they're just filter feeding out of the water, sort of like a coral does?
Yes. So bryozoans are little filter feeding polyps, quite similar to those of hydroids and corals. They have tentacles with little hairs on them that push the water through. They gather the particles, eat those particles, and then they go down a gut and come out of an anus that's situated outside of the circle of tentacles.
And then how does a bryozoan like get from one kelp to another kelp? How do they move around and reproduce, essentially?
So bryozoans produce sperm and eggs, and actually many of the species have special reproductive individuals. So if you look at them closely under the microscope, you can see certain individuals with large eggs in them. Then they will release those eggs, which float around, find a suitable substratum to settle on, and they turn into a single individual bryozoan-zoid, and then that will duplicate itself and duplicate itself and duplicate itself until it spreads out into a colony of genetically identical individuals.
Until it takes over the world.
Until it takes over the world. And they're actually extremely common. Almost every rock that you turn over, the underside of the rock is covered with bryozoans. It's just that the individuals are less than a millimeter long, and so they're not very conspicuous.
I've also noticed on the kelps, pretty much every kelp we look at has a little bryozoan growing on it somewhere.
Yes, several species of bryozoan grow on kelps or other seaweeds, and they tend to grow very flat on the surface, be white, and to have individual zoids that look like bricks. So the whole thing looks like a nicely designed brick paving on the surface of the kelp. Each one of those little bricks is an individual zoid. And the interesting thing about the ones that grow on the seaweeds is that they're a special species of nudibranch that graze only on those specific bryozoans. And the bryozoans, as I say, look a bit like brick paving. So the design on the back of the nudibranch is also like brick paving. So they're just little oval humps with this crisscross pattern on their back that looks like exactly like the bryozoan. So it's a fantastic example of camouflage. So this is another example of a beautiful and interesting group of animals where you've actually got to look pretty closely at it or take a close-up piece of video with your underwater camera and play it back on a big screen to appreciate the beauty of the animals and the way that they operate.